strategy aims at creating and sustaining a company's competitive advantage within the industry or business area it competes in. In order to formulate a strategy to pursue such goal, companies must embark in an analysis of their environment. Such investigation goes under the name of external strategy analysis. External strategy analysis aims at disclosing the industry's inner dynamics that may represent opportunities and threats competitors face. By doing so, external strategy analysis also allows to assess the industry level of attractiveness. Industry or market attractiveness refers to the current and expected average profitability of the firms operating in it. So, attractiveness is measured in terms of performance, in this case expressed by average margin. Such performance results from the interplay between trends labeled as opportunities and threats that could drive attractiveness up or down, respectively. Therefore, in strategy and economics, a market where players earn high profits on average compared to the averages of other markets or the whole economy are considered attractive, while poorly profitable markets are unattractive. Over time, several models to perform industry analysis and assess market attractiveness were proposed. However, one model stood out for its originality, comprehensiveness, and effectiveness. I'm talking about the five competitive forces model. The five competitive forces model was proposed by Professor Michael Porter from the Harvard Business School back in 1979, first published in the seminal Harvard Business Review article, How Competitive Forces Shape Strategy. This model was later included in another very influential publication from Porter, his 1980 book, Competitive Strategy, Techniques for Analyzing Industries and Competitors. The model is based on the following three basic assumptions. Competition is driven by industry structure, so competition in an industry is rooted in its underlying economics and depending on a market's structural determinants, the competition level may increase or decrease. For example, think of the number of players competing in the market as a structural determinant. As this number decreases, we come closer to a monopoly, where competition is limited. While should the number of competitors increase, we would approximate the ideal condition of a perfectly competitive industry, and competition itself would rise too. A second assumption posits that business area's attractiveness is inversely proportional to the level of competition of the competitive environment. Therefore, as competition in an industry increases, its attractiveness and average profitability of competitors decreases. And of course, the opposite happens when competition decreases. The lower the competition in an industry, the higher its attractiveness. These first two assumptions draw from traditional economic theory and offer little originality to industry analysis as it was conceived and performed when Porter crafted his model. However, Porter did make an original step as he offered a farther consideration. He argued that too often, competition in an industry is viewed too narrowly, as strategists tend to focus only on its established and well-known competitors, the so-called incumbents. Instead, competition goes well beyond the established competence in a particular industry. This is what he called extended rivalry, which gives a broader and more accurate picture of those drivers or competitive forces that determine industry attractiveness. According to Porter, extended rivalry is made of five competitive forces. First, intensity of internal rivalry, that is, the competition among incumbents. Second, potential new entrants, or all companies that do not belong to the business area under scrutiny, but may have the intention and the resources to enter it. Third, substitute products and services, all those alternatives to the market current offer that come from other markets and are technologically different from the industry products, but eventually satisfy the same needs. Fourth, the downstream bargaining power of the industry's buyers, may they be end users or business customers. And fifth, the bargaining power of suppliers upstream. It's a combination and interplay of these five forces to ultimately determine the level of industry attractiveness.